the Sister Circle live. He's one of the funniest comedians on the planet and has dubbed himself your favorite comic's favorite comic.
Please give a big Sister Circle welcome to Tony Rock. Yes!
Hello.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, come on, earrings.
Come on, bling. No, I'm in a circle full of sisters. What better way to start your morning?
Yeah, right. Absolutely, absolutely.
Tony, you come from a family of comedians. Yes. Chris, your brother Jordan, which is your youngest brother, and even you. Where did all this comedy come from? Were your parents funny?
Parents were super funny. Seven brothers, two sisters.
Your mama was busy.
Yeah, and when you don't have a lot growing up, you know, you start using your creative juices, you know,
right.
You use your imagination, you start impersonating family members and stuff like that, and that's where the comedy bug was, you know,
everybody
born.
Got it.
Yeah. Everybody got it.
Everybody got it.
So we know you've never used your brother's Chris's name to benefit you, but I hear Kenny does that to you.
Yes, Kenny.
Yeah.
Kenny's my younger brother, fairer skin, but looks just like me.
Okay.
Yes, he,
he tells girls he's Tony Rock.
Hilarious.
He gets free meals.
Wow, yeah.
He gets free meals in Brooklyn. He doesn't pay for drinks in Brooklyn because everybody thinks he's me.
How does that make you feel, though?
Oh, I love it. I love it.
Yeah.
That means I have a free meal somewhere waiting for me.
Exactly. Exactly. Yeah. You got to exercise your right.
And your cameraman, Gianni, didn't even know who I was. He's like, he looks like Chris Rock.
Oh!
I'm like, perfect.
All right. Does that bother you?
No, not at all.
Okay,
no,
good.
Wow. So I know, like myself, I have a bucket list as a comedian. So what is your bucket list? I know you're headlining, you're hosting the All Deaf General, and you just hosted, well, you're hosting Apollo Live. So talk to me, what is your bucket list? What have you not accomplished?
I was in the movie, a lot of people don't know this, I was in the movie Hitch. I had three scenes in the movie Hitch, me and Will going back and forth. Three scenes, and they cut all three of my scenes.
Wow. I didn't see you.
Yeah.
You ended
I went
up on
to the
floor.
Premiere. I went to the premiere with my boys from Brooklyn. I flew them all to L.A. We get there. I see Will, and he's like, oh, I forgot to tell you, your scenes are cut.
Oh, my God.
So you I sat through the whole movie with my friends, not telling them that I wasn't in the movie anymore.
Oh. You're talking about, I'm going to kill this show.
Yeah,
I'm going to kill it.
So bucket list would probably be to work with Will,
again.
Work with Denzel, you know.
Yeah.
Nice.
And your scenes not to be cut.
Not to be cut, yeah.
Yes, yes. Okay, so earlier this year, you know, Monique came out with this well-documented and saying that, and Netflix didn't offer her enough.
You know, make me talk about this again.
Well, I mean, would you have taken the money?
I would have taken the money because I think as an artist, getting your artistry out is the most important thing.
Yeah.
I think showing the world what you can do is the most important thing. I don't think any real artist goes into their artistry for the money.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Picasso didn't make a lot of money.
Right.
Beethoven didn't make a lot of money. You know, Edgar Allan Poe didn't make a lot of money. The art was what was enriching to them.
Yes.
So I would take the money just to get the art out to make people see how good I am.
Right, you know? Right. Well, recently you posted on your Instagram about a woman who accused you of saying something inappropriately to her 18-year-old daughter.
Yeah.
I know you wanted to clarify, you know, what happened that night.
All right, I'll try to give a long story and make it short.
Yes.
So I was in Southfield, Michigan. I came on stage. Excuse me. the young lady was sitting right in the front row, like about as close to me as you are.
Right.
And I get on stage, and she's texting as soon as I get on stage.
Oh, well.
Disrespectful.
So I say, hey, who are you texting? Like, the show just started. I'm here.
Right.
Let me be great. You know?
Right.
So she puts the phone away.
Okay.
5 minutes later, I look, she's texting again. So I'm like, what are you, setting up a booty call for later?
Right.
If that's the case, I'll leave it alone, because I know sometimes it'd be hard.
Right.
So she's, sorry. 5 minutes later, she's on the phone again. She's so close, I take the phone out her hand. And she says, it's my friend, I'm getting married. It's my friend, I'm getting married, and she's not being supportive of my marriage.
Mm-hmm.
I said, so she's not showing up for rehearsals, she's not doing stuff she wanted to do. She said, yeah. I said, get her on the phone, let's get this clarified so I can get to work.
Right.
This is distracting
me. So now this has become part of the show.
Right. So now the room's like, oh, no, he didn't. It's like old Def Jam.
Right.
He did.
Right. It's a thing.
Right. So she calls, I put her on speakerphone. I'm like, listen, your girl trying to get married, let her be great. Let her live, shine.
Right.
Show up, wear the ugly dress and just take pictures. And then, you know, it's her day. It's the most important day of her life. Stop being a hater. Click, hang up the phone. Room's like, oh, he killed it. She puts the phone away. 10 minutes later, No. After I do that, I put the phone in my back pocket.
Uh-huh. Oh, so now she's mad.
So now she's like, I got to call her later. I got to call her. I'm like, well, we'll call her at the end of the show.
Right.
So now I'm wrapping the show up, and I get the phone to give it back to her. And she goes, I have to call my girl. I can't believe you did that. I say, get her on the phone. I'll explain to her what happened.
Yeah.
She answered the phone. She answered the phone like, girl, I ain't trying to be part of your damn comedy show.
Right.
So you talk to me later. So I said, well, then forget you, B. Click.
Oh, got it.
Everybody went crazy. I ended the show like that. The girl dying laughing. At the end of the show, you know me. I take pictures with everybody in the room after the show. If it was a problem, she could have came over and said, hey, I didn't think you should have said it to my girl.
Right.
Now, this is what happened. The girl who I said it to was not at the comedy show, of course. Her mother wasn't at the show either.
So her mama did
she
that.
She told her mother what happened, and mother went on social media and tried to get it going. So she was like, I want this to go viral. So I'm like, okay, well, I'll help you make it go viral.
Right, because I need
it. I'll put
it
on my page.
Turn up. Yes.
Gotcha.
And now people are like, yo, you shouldn't have said that. First of all, if you walk in a comedy club, there's no way for me to know what's going to offend your sensibilities, what word you don't want to hear, what thing you're against, what thing you're for. So what I do is talk to the room like I'm talking to my friends.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
I call my female friends B every once in a while. I call my male friends N every once in a while. They know it's all love because it's not my character to degrade them. They're my friends.
Mm-hmm.
So to ingratiate myself with the room, I talk to you like I talk to my friends.
Right. Don't go anywhere. More with Tony Rock after this. What an amazing explanation.
Yes.
You did.
I love it.
And we are back with the hilarious Tony Rock.
Yes, now Tony, you are on tour right now with Mike Epps, D-Ray Davis. What, like, when are you doing another tour? But you're doing another tour.
I'm doing my tour. I do like comedy clubs, you know, more intimate settings, 400, 500 seats.
Got it. 400, 500 seats.
That's my tour.
Right.
And then I'm on tour with Mike and D-Ray and Mike Blackson and Ricky Smiley.
Yeah,
and I want to shout Mike out because Mike could have had anybody open his tour and he got some gorillas going in front of him.
Yes,
really.
So you got to really be sure what you're doing to put that much power in front of you and still be able to follow it. So shout out to Mike.
What's your process like in writing?
Everything. I read the paper. I write. I talk to my friends. I write. I go to the barbershop. I see what they're talking about. Mm-hmm. I write. Pop culture. Of course, there's always something going on in pop culture. I write. Sometimes when I have writer's block, I write as if I'm somebody else just to get out of writer's block. Like, if I'm writer's block for, like, 2 days, I'll say, okay, today I'm Eddie Murphy. What would Eddie Murphy write today?
I write
jokes.
Yeah.
But I can never use them because they're based on, but it's just to get out of the block.
Yeah.
You know, get out of my own way.
I love it.
Real quickly, what was your response to Miss Wolf, who was at the correspondence
Michelle
dinner?
Michelle Wolf. She was great. Michelle Wolf was amazing.
Yeah.
It was amazing. It was power-packed. It was the people. She was the voice of the people. I love it. I love it.
Awesome.
Love
and you are the voice of the people, too.
Yes, sir.
Tony Rock. Thank you so much for coming down to the Circle.
Thank
for more information on Tony Rock, make sure to follow Sister Circle TV on all of our social networks.
And the conversation always continues at SisterCircleTV.com.
The amazing Tony Rock.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes. You are the man.
I was about to call that lady a whole other name.
Michelle.
Yeah. It slipped. I was like, whoa.